We're at IBC 2017. I'm Kirk Harnack at the Telos Alliance. We're talking about virtualizing radio. You know, that can mean a lot of things to a lot of people. And Sasha and Joel are system integrators from Germany. And Joel, you had some ideas about virtualizing radio and the benefits when it comes to the IT world in terms of efficiency. What were you telling me about that idea?
Yeah, usually from my experience, if you virtualize stuff and make it so you can send subcell sections of it to other people and make give the possibility to other people to outsource it, the technology becomes more available to people who do not have the funding to get the technologies themselves. So
like instead of purchasing an audio console, if you could rent some server space in the cloud, or maybe even your own server space, the point is do it in software, on a machine that can do other things as well, you can gain some efficiency and reduce the price of entry.
Yes, exactly that.
Okay, and this is done in the IT world all the time. You can run a bunch of machines that are virtual machines on a larger machine and come out better than if you had all these individual computers, yeah?
Yes, exactly. And there are people who own big servers who sell subsections of that as virtual machines to other people. So it's exactly like that.
So the idea is maybe I could put my codec or my phone system or my mixer on an Amazon web server, for example.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly. So and you would save a lot of money because you do not have to buy the codec, which is probably very expensive.
And you made another point about if you buy a piece of hardware and you're probably only using a small part of its capability, but if you virtualize this, then you can fill up the host machine with work, yeah?
Yes, and you do not need to buy the hardware that you don't need, but you only rent the parts that you need and pay for them.
This does sound like reducing the barrier to entry. Sasha, have you got some ideas about virtualization, whether it's just remote control from an IP tablet or anything putting the whole radio station up in the cloud?
Beside the hardware part, there's also the personal part, so the guys who operate this or who keep it running.
Yeah.
So you don't have to invest in technicians and observing everything is running smoothly, so you can just use it as a service, buy it as a service, and they keep it up and running, and you can concentrate on that, what you want to do, like making radio.
Yes, yeah. I guess the barrier, or one barrier to getting into this kind of world, is the connectivity between a broadcaster's physical location, whether it's home, office, an outside broadcast, and this data center, server area, wherever it may be. But the world is quickly overcoming these challenges, yeah?
Yes, we have 4G networks, we have audio channels that are low latency capable over unreliable networks. We can overcome these problems easily.
So in your work now with broadcasters, you have a lot of connectivity between the broadcaster and other facilities, yeah?
Yeah, and IP seems to be the cure for every problem in the last years. So, and I never, I don't think the startup problems we had with IP are now almost gone. And everyone is familiar with it and knows how to do certain things on IP networks, and that making it a lot easier. And back in the days, you had like serial connections, and you had to deal with baud rates, and something like this.
Yeah.
And now you have IP, and everyone talks IP, and it's really awesome, I think. It makes it easier to integrate things.
I think, Sasha, you just invented the next acronym. We have AOIP, we have VOIP. Telos is actually next door to a brewery, so we have BOIP, beer over IP.
Do you?
Yes, but now we have EOIP, everything over IP.
Yes,
that's great. I'm Kirk Harnack, along with Sasha and Joel here at IBC 2017.